When thinking of improving your health, what is the first thing that comes to mind? Maybe starting a workout regimen, eating a healthier diet, drinking more water, getting a physical, quitting a bad habit, or getting more sleep?
Hanging out with friends even cross your mind? Countless studies have found that socialization and support from friends, a spouse, or family strongly associate with positive physical and mental health. These studies found that a social component can improve your mood, lower your stress levels, discourage damaging behavior, improve positive behavior, boost your cardiovascular health, strengthen your immune system, and even boost the effects of exercise. Duchar, May 2019. As you age, social isolation can contribute to a multitude of diseases such as Alzheimer's disease, heart disease, and cognitive decline. 2019. In this speech, I want to persuade you to look at your health in a different way. I want to persuade you to hang out with friends, make new friends, and live a more sociable life. Social isolation contributes to hind and early effects of various dangerous health conditions. Medical article from 2019 states that research has linked social isolation and loneliness to higher risks for a variety of physical and mental conditions. The same article states that high blood pressure, obesity, weakened immune system, heart disease, anxiety, depression, cognitive decline, Alzheimer's disease, dementia, and even death can occur earlier in a person's life if they are socially isolating compared to someone who is not. The novel Cassiopeia, Evolutionary Theory of Loneliness states, loneliness automatically triggers a set of behavioral and biological processes that contribute to the association between loneliness and premature death. On a more personal note, my grandfather's health rapidly declined after his three closest friends died. Before their passing, he worked on his farm every day and had no serious health conditions. He then isolated himself from my grandmother and the rest of our family. After this, he was diagnosed with dementia and Alzheimer's disease. We soon realized that we could not take care of him ourselves and needed help. We put him into a nursing home for 30 days and then realized that his health wasn't getting any better. He moved in with me, my mom, my dad, and my little sister. And after 30 days, he passed away. Lucky for us, though, we don't all have to be like my grandfather. There are 7 billion people in this world, and one of them is bound to like you. Now, you might be asking yourself, where should I start? Well, the Mayo Clinic can help you with that. They state that you could find potential friends from people you already know, such as coworkers, former or fellow classmates, past or childhood friends, acquaintances from social gatherings, or people who share a family tie with you. Meeting people isn't always easy, but you have to make an effort. You will have to broaden your horizon and not be afraid to be persistent, and sometimes take the initiative yourself. You could try going to community events. You could volunteer. You'll have to accept invitations, make plans, take up a new interest, or even go to a bar or restaurant that you've never been to before. You might be saying, Avery, how am I going to make friends during a pandemic? Well, good thing we live in the age of the internet. The Mayo Clinic states that there are many ways that you can make friends online. You can join a chat group, create a social media profile, or even join a dating website. Bumble is a popular dating app, but it's not just a dating app. In fact, you can change your settings to looking for friends. I used it when I first moved to Florida to find friends. When finding friends online, it is especially important to be safe. Never give out your personal information like your location or bank information. Sometimes people are not always who they say they are. Especially in times like these, the internet is a great way to make new friends and stay in touch with them. But my hope for you is that when this whole pandemic is over, that you will hang out with your friends face to face. You need it. A medical article from 2019 states that social media, when used so much that it infringes on face-to-face quality time, was tied to greater loneliness, while having meaningful in-person interactions, reported high levels of social support, and being in a committed relationship were associated with less loneliness. The same article emphasizes that social media should be used judiciously and strategically, and not as a replacement for in-person relationships. Instead, we should use technology to seek meaningful connections and people that you are going to be able to keep in your social sphere. Now it is time to make a choice. Close your eyes and visualize with me. Visualize your life surrounded by people that you love. I'll give you a minute. Now, while keeping your eyes closed, visualize your life without your loved ones and best friends. It should be easy to see the benefits, and the answer to which life you would choose should be as clear as day. We can choose to not surround ourselves with friends and love. We can choose to go out to dinner alone, doing everything alone, staying home alone all the time, and never talking to anyone.
Can you see how this will negatively affect your physical and mental health?
We can choose to live a life with love and have a vibrant social life.
We can go out to dinner with our friends and family.
We can share our activities with a friend.
We can host and go to parties.
And we can always have at least one person to talk to.
See how this will positively affect your physical and mental health?
I'm leaving you with a visual choice.
You get to pick the life you live.
Friends or no friends, when this pandemic is all over, I encourage you to go to the restaurant that you've never been to before.
Accept a party invitation or friend request.
Get back in touch with your high school best friend.
But of course, right now, be safe while you do it.
I urge you to get out there and socialize like your life depends on it,
because in reality, it does.